exceptional world in Bernoulli site percolation.
Thank you. Guattardi, thank you very much, the organizer, for the invitation. It's good to be back in Rio. Thank you, especially special thanks to Marcelo for the adventurous hike of Saturday. Today I will talk about a problem related to site percolation. So this morning in the talk of Hugo, you saw bond percolation. So we were studying like throwing coins to bonds, and bonds were open with probability p, closed with probability 1 minus p. In here we look at something very similar, except that this is the site, as each site will receive a 1 with probability p and a 0 with probability 1 minus p. And the standard question in percolation, as it was introduced in the 60s, was to understand the existence of long chains of ones. So this was a standard model. And in the 80s, there were some questions asked about different patterns, not necessarily sequence of ones, but sequence of words. What kind of a sequence I can read in my percolation picture by following a self-avoiding path? And so this will be the question of what words can be read in the percolation picture. So a word would just be a sequence of 0 and 1. In this talk, I will first recall briefly what is site percolation, because we will use some previous knowledge about site percolation. So I will recall it briefly. And then I will talk about the question, if I fix a word, mean an infinite sequence of 0 and 1, can I read it in the percolation picture? So we will give some partial answer to this question. And then the last step, and this is where I will present new result, the question is, what is the set of all words that I can read somewhere in the percolation picture? You will see this question is different in flavors. So let's start with just recalling site percolation. If I start to write too small, don't hesitate to complain in the back if you cannot read. So the graph here will be ZD. So just the standard d-dimensional square lattice with edges between the nearest neighbor. So let me draw a little bit a piece of Z2. So I fix a parameter p between 0 and 1. And for every site, so every vertex of ZD, I associate a number, 1 or 0, with probability, 1 with probability p and 0 with probability 1 minus p. So I get a random configuration, omega, which is just an element of 0, 1 to the ZD. And omega of a vertex is 1 with probability p and 0 with probability 1 minus p. And I will write p in this sub p, which is just the percolation measure, the reality in probability measure on the product space 0, 1 to the ZD. So as I said, we standard site percolation. We're interested in the following event. So here it's site percolation. So we start, maybe this is the origin. I want to put the one here. Is the event that starting at 0, I can read along an infinite path. So there exists an infinite self-avoiding path, so meaning different vertices. starting at zero and made of only one vertices, made of ones. So, for example, here, if it's my origin, I'm asking whether in this picture I can read an infinite path just by going only on one vertices. And as for bound percolation, there is a phase transition. There exists a critical value, PC of D. So there is a phase transition, which at a critical parameter that depend on the dimension, below this critical parameter, the probability that I found such a path is zero, and above, it becomes positive. So okay, it's clear. It's exactly as we did this morning is for bound percolation, except now we are just interested in paths along which all the sites are one. And the result, the previous result that will be interesting for us. So in general, actually, for site percolation, the value of PC is really not known. We don't know it. But for our problem, what will be important will be the position of PC with respect to 1/2. So the theorem says the following. So in dimension 2, actually, for this model, the critical value is strictly larger than 1/2. So as Hugo said this morning, there is just one number. So our question is just what is the position relative to this only number between 0 and 1. So and in dimension larger, the critical value gets strictly smaller than 1/2 when d is larger than or equal to 3. So this is a. These results are all theorem. That goes back to Campanino and Russo for this one. This can be easily deduced from the work of Eisenman and Grimmett in the 90s. But I don't want to give more detail. Just you to have in mind that we know these two properties about the critical value. Okay, this is all what we need from site percolation. Maybe I can reuse. So let's move to 2. Now word percolation. So we will change. We will keep exactly the same framework at the beginning. And so what we are interested in, and maybe it's not so clever to do. So word percolation. So first, as I said, we will be interested in the question if I fix a word. So what would be a word? Just I fix a word, fix xi, which is just an infinite sequence of 0 and 1. And I consider the following event, 0 goes to infinity with xi is just the fact that there exists an infinite path starting at 0 an infinite path given notation pi which is just pi 0 pi 1, and I want it to be self-avoiding as before, such that the first vertex of my path is 0, And at each time, for every I, omega of pi I is psi I. So for example, if this is, let's make it a little bit bigger. So if this is my origin, I start at zero and I don't know, for example, here, I start by this path. And this is a beginning of the event that zero is connected to infinity by the path that starts by zero, by 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, and so on. So this is illustrated here. Okay, it's clear? Yeah. What? Yeah, P0 is the origin. It's just the starting point of my path. It's omega of P0. This zero is not has nothing to do with this one. This is the zero of CD. Okay, so it's clear. Before we were just interested in seconds of one. Now we just want to know if we can read this word psi. Already lost my. So there are some particular case. Particular cases. So if we consider the word psi, which is just a constant word 1, just 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, this is just standard side percolation, what I mentioned in the beginning. There is another case that was considered in the 80s. It's just the alternative word, the word which is 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, and so on and so forth. And this is this was called AB percolation. And the case of general words was formalized in a paper in 95 by Benjamin and Kesten. And this was really this question, the foundational word, where most of the questions were asked. And I will give a first theorem that answers partially. So before, maybe let me mention the kind of difficulty that happened with considering general words. If you consider this word, we saw that Hugo mentioned this morning that the event is increasing. So if I'm asking whether I can read the word 1111, when p increases, it gets easier to read this word. If you start to take words with 0 and 1, it's no longer the case. So you lose this monotonicity property. So this is something that makes the problem a little bit more difficult to investigate. In particular, for a single word, it's not clear what is the set of p where you can read it. It's no longer an interval. There is no natural critical value. So, but nevertheless, there is something that we can say that will be the most important thing for us today to have in mind. So it's a theorem it's due to Wirman in 89 and Benjamini and Kesten. In 95. So the theorem says the following, that it says that for every psi, so for every word that I fix, for every parameter p, the probability that zero is connected to infinity reading the word psi, it's always larger than the minimum of the probability that I can read the word zero and the probability that I can read the word, the constant word one. So, in other words, the hardest word to read is just the constant word. So I will not give the details of the proof, but I will just give you the idea why it is true. So let's just consider a simple case. So just a very simple question. I consider the graph. Just let me mention here the reference tool, but just the theorem was actually proved by Virman in 85 in the case of AB percolation. So for these words, so he proved that the AB words is always has always a larger probability to be for the constant words. And Beniamini and Kesten, in their when they generalized the question, they just explained that the remark that the proof of Virman extends to general words. Sorry, what?
This is zero, the minimum, no?
Yeah. Of these two?
Yeah.
No? If you can, this will come later. It's possible that both zero and one percolate. This will be exactly why the position of PC is important. So that's a good remark. Actually, you are right in dimension two. In dimension two, as we saw this morning, we cannot have both one and zero that percolates. But when you go in higher dimension, then you can have. So, but this will come later. You are completely right that in dimension two, it's this says nothing. Okay, so yeah, I was just let me. So a simple case. I just consider the following graph, a very, very simple graph, which is just five vertices. Why five, I don't know. OK, five. And I just put the origin of my graph here, and I have a vertex here, x. And I'm just interested if I can read some word from 0 to x. So I just fix a word size. This time it's just 0, 1, 2, 5. And if I compute the probability that 0 is connected to x by reading the word xi, so exactly the good word, this is just p to the number of 1s in xi. And 1 minus p to the number of zeros in xi. OK? This is just completely a trivial computation. But you see that this is minimal. So if p is smaller than 1 half, this is larger than p to the 5. And if p is larger than 1 half, it's larger than 1 minus p to the 5. So this is always larger than the minimum of p to the 5. 1 minus p to the 5. Depending on the position of p between 1 and half, and this is just the probability that 0 is connected to x by reading the word 1, and this is equal to the probability 0 is connected to x reading the word 0. OK, so in this very simple case, it's completely obvious. And in general, so why is it intuitive? Let's say, for example, we take p smaller than 1 half. We want to say that the harder word is the constant one. If I take a word where I start to have zeros, the zero will cost me less than the ones. So when p is smaller than 1 half, the harder word to read is a constant word one, because the zero are easier to see. And when p is larger than 1 half, this is the opposite. OK, so it's clear. And the reason why you can extend to a general graph, so not this one, is due just by a suitable coupling. You can just make a coupling between a percolation where, when as soon as you have a path of ones on the on one configuration, it implies a path of psi on the configuration on the right. So it's not completely obvious. It's the intuition is sufficient. Okay, so maybe let me write your remark, because I think it's, if we are in dimension 2, when d equal 2, there is the, if we are, for example, at 1 half, the probability to read the word 0 is equal to the probability to read the word 1, it's 0. So in dimension 2, there is no parameter for where at which we can see all words. At your best parameter, you cannot see the constant words. So we will not focus on this case. There are interesting questions also in dimension 2, but for us, not be interested in these questions, because then there are still questions at which words can we see. This will be more interested in can we see all the words. But a corollary of the following theorem is that if I go in dimension d equal to 3, larger than 3, then if I take P between PC of D and strictly and 1 minus PC of D, then the probability, then for every Xi, the probability that 0 is connected to infinity by reading the word Xi, this is positive. And since PC is strictly smaller than 1 half, this is a non-trivial interval. Just let me make a picture. So we're in dimension D larger than 3. So now we know PC is smaller than 1 half. And 1 minus PC there. PC of D. 1 minus PC of D. When I am above 1 PC, I can read the word 1. And since I am below 1 minus PC, I can also read the word 0. So these two quantities are positive. So by our theorem, this implies that for every Xi, the probability of 0 connected to infinity by reading Xi is positive. Okay, it's clear to know? So this was what I wanted to say when we fix a word and ask if we can read this word. And we identify in dimension D larger than 3 a whole regime of parameters where we can see with positive probability all these words. You see that the place of all these words will play a role now. So let's move to the next level, which is 3. Let's try to reading all the words. I want to introduce a quantity. So given a configuration, so now we are all the time in dimension d larger than 3. So I want to define the random set, which is just S infinity, which is just all the set of all words, xi in 0, 1 to n, such that there exists a vertex v in Zd from such that if I start from v, so the vertex v, I can starting from v going to infinity by reading the word xi. So I fix a configuration and I look at all the words that I can read somewhere in my configuration. So this, I will always refer to all the words that can be read. So please note this definition, because I will use now a lot this set, so it's important that it's clear. OK, what can we say? Because we have seen things in the previous section, we have seen that every fixed word can be read. So this already has consequences about our set. We will start by a remark. If I write mu, which is just a measure, 1/2 delta 0 plus 1/2 delta 1 to the power n, so just the product measure, on the set of words. So we know that a fixed word exists with positive I can read a fixed word from zero with positive probability. And therefore, by ergodicity, a fixed word I can read somewhere in the graph with probability one. So now, by a Fubini, what we can deduce, we can deduce that the probability that the measure of S infinity is 1, this occurs with probability 1. So in the set of words, all the words that I can read, they have a full measure. So let me just write the argument. It's basically what I said, but I want just to be clear here. So for a fixed xi, the probability that xi belongs to S infinity, so this is a measure, this event, xi belongs to infinity, is an invariant, is translation invariant. So it has a 0-1 probability. And I forgot one thing, is when p is between pc of d and 1 minus pc. So when p is between pc and 1 minus pc, I know that the probability of this event is positive. It has a 0, 1 law, so it's 1. So this is just the corollary that we have. Maybe, the corollary that I've written here, plus ergodicity. And then, to deduce this, we just apply Fubini. So you see, there is a subtlety here, is that a priori, a natural question is that whether we can see all words. A priori, just the fact that we can read with probability one each word, we just get that it has full measure. And a natural question, this is the main question that I want to discuss. And this is a question which was raised in the work of Benjamin and Kesten. Do we have, so I take P between PC of D, 1 minus PC of D, and the question is, do we have that the probability that S infinity is equal to all the words, is it equal to 1? And let me just say something like this is a non-trivial question. And so in their work, Benjamin and Kesten, actually they constructed a graph where the set of words that you can read in the percolation picture and a good parameter such that the set of words has full measure, but not all the words can be read. And later also it was proved that by Sidoravicius and Kesten that in the triangular lattice, at PC equal 1 half, we know that we cannot read the constant words 0, 0, 0, 0, and 1, 1, 1. The two don't percolate, but still the set of words that can be read have full measure. So the fact that the set of words has full measure implies that I can read a word is absolutely not trivial. And actually, this question is so non-trivial that actually even the question itself is non-trivial. This, if you think of it, what is it? It's the intersection that I can read the word psi, but the set of words is not countable. So the fact that this is measurable is not clear either. So it's actually a result, and it's a very nice argument. The fact that S infinity of psi is a set of all words, the fact that this is measurable, so it is actually, and it's a result of also Benjamin and Kesten. What's the proof? And the argument is a bare category argument. So using a bare argument, they actually show that this event corresponds, is completely equivalent to the fact that you can find a box from where you can see a word. And then this is measurable. But this is not trivial. So it's a bare argument. Okay, so now I will state the theorem, the main theorem. So if you take D larger than 3, P between PC and 1 minus PC, then the probability that we can read all the words in the percolation picture, this is 1. So we answer positively to this question in the full in the whole regime. And let me just mention some previous results, what was previously known. So the first case which was known is a case of d larger than 10 and p equal 1/2. And actually a neighborhood of 1/2, but not the full regime PC 1 minus PC. And this was achieved, the idea was to say that if the dimension is large, I can find some kind of nice snake with 0 and 1. And in this snake, using this snake exists with perturbative methods. And in these snakes, I can find all the words that I want. But it's really a perturbative. I need to be close to 1/2. I cannot go to the full region. Another, so this was due to Benjamin. No, but it's, yeah. So it's a fat snake. So I'm asking a snake which is made of 0 and 1, which are positioned in a suitable way that I'm sure that I can find. You can find, like, I give something which is it's not completely obvious to do, but imagine you have each time you can choose between 1 and 0, and in your snake you find. So it's very combinatorial proof. The second result is due to Ilario De Lima, Nolan, and Sidoravicius in 2014. They consider Xi M, which is just a set of words where each time I have occurrence of a letter, it appears at least M times. So it's a word that I do not oscillate too much. It's a family of words. It's a very big family. It has positive measure. And they proved that this time in dimension d larger than 3, that the probability of Xi m is included in S infinity is 1. For m large enough.
What do you mean by it has positive measure?
In terms of the for this measure, you can make any kind of distance of a length of 0 and 1.
Yeah, but
okay, consider this kind of I need to think 2 seconds. Okay, consider this. Yeah, I think I agree with you. It's recorded. Okay. It has a positive measure if you choose the suitable measure. I didn't precise the measure. Okay. Now I'm lost. What did I want to say? Okay, so... I'm lost. Let's continue. Let's move to the proof, idea of proof. How much time? Yeah. So let's do the... Sorry? That's what I wanted to say. So d larger than 3 and m large enough. Okay. So, proof. Okay, how do we can try to prove it? So I just go in a direction which is natural. The probability that S infinity is not all the world . This is just the probability that there exists a word such that Xi does not belong to S infinity. Okay, now I use the union bound. And this is zero. And I'm done. Okay. So it was a long standing conjecture, and this is a proof. So of course, I spent many time explaining to you that we use Fubini and so on. So what is the mistake I make here? Yeah. So this set is not countable. So we cannot do it. But still, I wanted to write this proof because this is actually our starting point. Because actually, and this is very brutal, and the idea of the proof will be to use a union bound. So in some sense, if you manage to make this quantitative, so to restrict to the right number of words in a certain box, and the probability are good enough, you will manage to apply this proof. So that's why I write it in small, so it's tempting proof, unfortunately wrong. Unfortunately. Okay. So in the last 5 minutes, I will try to explain to you how we make this proof working. So the idea will be to do the following. So proof. So first, by symmetry, we can just assume p is smaller than 1/2. So I just take p between pc of d and 1/2. And the idea will be to consider an event, so that I will describe quickly, en. So I fix k large, and I consider the box lambda k, which is minus k, k to the d. And I will consider an event, which is the following. Starting from lambda k, I can find many words, so the number of x, such that starting from the box, I can go to the, so this is a box of size lambda n. I can go from this box to x by reading a word which is smaller than c of length cn by reading the beginning of the word xi. So this is an event, en of xi. And I'm asking that this number of x, so this number of point, this, I'm asking that it's larger than some delta n to the d minus 1. So I'm asking that the number of x at the boundary that I can reach using the word xi, they have a density. OK? So I'm asking something quite strong. I'm just not asking that I can go to the box, but I'm really asking that I can go to a density. And just a lemma, simple lemma. And this is all in this lemma, but I will not prove, is the fact that if I can reach distance n, I can have this event for every xi. If I have en of xi, but not e2n of xi, this event has a very, very small probability. Okay? So I see Rob smiling, so I think he understood now how it will go. And this I will not prove, but actually, if you understood the idea at the beginning, this, if you take the word one, it's a well-known fact for supercritical percolation. The fact that creating a density, like connecting two sets with density as a probability which is exponential in the surface, is a well-known fact. And just then, using in a suitable way the coupling, we can extend to words. So this is just a supercritical lemma for standard percolation that we extend to words. So it's not so surprising. Yeah? Yeah, so that's a good point. In this picture, what I mean by that is I read the beginning of Xi. So Xi is an infinite word. And I'm just asking that I can read the beginning of Xi. This is what I'm saying. But I can read along Cn. And maybe now I can just finish the proof with this as an input and try to make. So the idea is that if I look at the probability that there exists a word Xi such that I can not read from lambda k to infinity, it means, so we know at the beginning I already have a density, the event ek occurs surely. So this is smaller than the sum of all n larger than k. And this time, you know, I just asking that the probability that there exists a word Xi for which En occurs, but not E2N. If there exists a word which fails, it means that at some point En occurs, but not 2N occur for some word. But now you see what is nice is that I have fixed N. So I don't need to look at all the words. I just need to look at the words which have length smaller than Cn. So this union now is finite. And now I can apply the union bound. And then I use my lemma. And this very brutal bound is sufficient. Because this now, the number of words is 2 to the Cn. And this, if I take k large enough, this is smaller than 1/2. So with positive probability, I see all words from the box of size k, and therefore I see all words with probability 1. This concludes the proof. So I hide the technicalities here. And actually, the most, just before finish, the real difficulty is to keep track of this length. Obrigado para sua atenção. Sofia.
So we have time for